Hello and welcome to this video tutorial on how to build your own Isinga web module. My name is Marcus, I'm a consultant at NetWays, and here at NetWays we work with Isinga to provide an awesome monitoring experience. For this tutorial you only need to know a little bit of PHP and HTML, and yeah, let's get started. All right. In this video, I'll show you how to set up your development environment, everything you need to get started, and how an Isinga web module is structured, so which files and directories you will need to create. To get started, we need PHP installed, which I got here. So you see it's 8.2, so a recent installation. And I also need Isinga Web, of course, installed. So let's have a look at that. Isinga Web. As you can see, installed in the default path. This is just a vanilla installation based on the official documentation, nothing fancy. Already got my web server and my database running. So just followed the official installation. And it's up and running, and I can log in. Let's try that. It works. As you can see, it's up and running. I also got Isinga Core installed, but that's not necessary for this tutorial. Just Isinga Web is sufficient. For the development, you can also use the Isinga CLI, which provides a web server for development. This is a nice feature. So you can use the Isinga CLI web serve, designate a port, and it'll start you a development web server which will ship this directory. This is nice if you don't want any web server or anything else installed. This is nice for testing. I myself use a VM, which you can see here. I use Vagrant Homestead, which is a nice little development VM which bundles a lot of stuff for web development. So as you can see, I have a lot of PHP versions installed, old ones and new ones. This is nice for testing. This is nice for developing for different PHP versions, making sure everything runs with all these versions. It also comes with the database and with various other stuff. So I like working with Homestead. It's a very nice setup. But you can use whatever you want to install your Isinga web. So as long as you got an Isinga web instance running, you're good to go. In order to get started with our own map module, let's have a look at where they live and how to create one. You might be familiar with the configuration modules page, where you can see all the modules that are installed on your system. So like I said, I have a plain vanilla installation with the monitoring module, the translation module, and the docs module, for example. These are all installed, might not be active, but they are present on my system. In the back, these are just directories in a folder, like so. So inside the Isinga web directory, we have the modules directory, and in this directory, we have the directories which contain all the code for each module, like the monitoring module. So if we create, for example, let's just give it a try, a modules test directory, and we reload this page, we see, oh, it detected a test module. This module contains nothing, does nothing, but it automatically got detected. Right, and if I delete it again, let's give it a try, delete it. It's gone again. And inside these folders, we have all the code that provides the functionality for the given module. So as you can see here, these have a similar structure. Let's have a look at the translation module. This is a similar structure. This is the structure. This is the anatomy of our modules. You can have a detailed look at our training module, which is also based on this course. And if you have a look at the introduction, you can see this nice little overview on how to structure your module. First, let's set up a directory in our modules directory. As you can see, I already created this, so never mind the error. Let's just create a training directory. With this directory, we can see the module appearing in our list. So refresh. We have no version and no description. Let's change that and create a file called module.info. And let's paste in some very important details. Save and refresh. And you can see it is now appearing in our web interface. It's currently disabled, that's all right, we haven't enabled it. And now we can provide additional information which will appear in the web interface. Save and refresh, and you can see now it appears here. We have no dependencies declared, we can also declare dependencies here in this file. Let's do that later, we don't have any dependencies for now. So with this in place, we can enable our module. We can do this with a nice little button here, which will enable or disable our module. We can also do this in the CLI. Let's select it and let's switch to our console. And we can now use the Isinga CLI module list, for example, and see we have these two enabled. And we want to see everything that is installed. We see the training module in this version. It's currently disabled. Let's enable this guy. And let's say enable and then training. So let's see. It's now enabled. So this is the same functionality which the web interface provides. And now we can create content and functionality and extend our Isinga web instance with this. This should now be enabled. Let's refresh. There it is. Before we dive into web development and web design, let's have a small little peek into the CLI, so the command line interface. So I previously said that we can create an application folder, and inside this application folder we can create a CLI commands folder. This is the place where all our command line interface would live. So let's switch back to the shell, and like the command line here, we can have functionality in the shell, and we can also provide this in our web module. So let's create a file here. New file. Let's just call it hello command.php. And And inside this, we can write PHP code, obviously. Every component needs to be in its own namespace here. So we now use the namespace Isinga module training. This is the name of the module. So let's switch back. See, this is training. This also needs to correspond with the directory training. So we're inside the training directory. And this one lives inside the CLI commands. And now we're gonna use the CLI class provided by Isinga Web to create a hello world command. And it'll look like this. So we're gonna extend the comment class. Let's call it hello command and save this. And this should already work. Let's have a look. If we use the CLI with no additional parameters, we can now see available modules. We have a training module, and this means we can now use training as a subcommand. And here you can see we now have the hello action available, or the hello command available, and this comment can now have actions. So we can now say Isinga CLI training hello, and then provide additional actions that we want to take. For example, database cleanup jobs, or any other maintenance stuff, or you can even write a check plugin for Isinga Core with this and ship it with your web module, for example. So this does nothing at the moment. Let's change that. And let's provide a nice little hello world function or method, since we're working on an object. All right, so we now create a public function with the suffix action. This is important. And world will be the comment that we will use in the CLI. And we'll just echo hello world. Let's see how that works. It works. Since I only have one action, I don't need to specify which action. Let's just be more precise and say we want to use the hello comment and use its world action, as you can see here. And then it'll print out hello world, which is nice. And we can also use PHP's function documentation as so. So I'll just provide some documentation for my function. And this is nice because now I can use the help, and it'll just print that out on the terminal. So now this prints hello world to the console, and this seems to be true if I type it in correctly. Furthermore, we can also use some functions that the comment class provides to get the parameters which the user might provide via the CLI. So for example, we can now say hello world from, and we want to get this from variable based on the parameter which the user can provide here. So I want to say hello from, for example, Nuremberg, where I currently sit. This doesn't work. I haven't saved yet. Let's save this. And it works. So hello from Nuremberg. We use the params, and we will shift these params. So this is quite common in lots of programming languages, that you have CLI parameters which you then shift. So shift will remove the Nuremberg string and store it into this variable. And then we can use that variable for anything we want. And we can have multiple shifts and then just pop these of the array. Right. Let's also provide some nice little documentation. Let's say this will print a parameter to the console. Let's now use the help again, dash dash help. And yeah, that works. So we have now hello world. This will greet the world, and the from subcommand will print the parameter to the console. And if I don't specify anything, now that I have two actions, we need to be more precise. We need to say which action we want. Hello world and hello from. Yeah, from nowhere. We can also have named parameters, which I am a big fan of, since they are a bit more, let's say, carry more semantics. So for example, we can now have let's say by or by whom action. So we want to get the who parameter, the named parameter from the CLI, store it in this variable, and then use the same variable again to echo something. And we will use the second parameter to the function here, to the method, to specify a default. So we will try to get the named parameter who. If we don't find it, we will use nobody. Did I save already? Yes, let's give it a try. Dash dash help. By, and we can now say hello by, and it'll say nobody says hello. And now I can use dash dash who to say hello from Marcus, and it'll print that out to the console. Let's also provide documentation, since we are good little programmers. And somebody says hello, this is the usage, so we can here provide all the necessary information on how to use each action. And if we have a look at the help again, somebody says hello, and then we can even be more precise and say, give me the help for the buy action. And now we can see the usage here, and give it a try again. Works perfectly. Yeah, and this is how you would build a CLI. I know I'm the tutorial is named Web Modules, but this is a big part of just functionality that is provided by modules. So a lot of Isinga Web Modules also provide CLI tools. All right, that's it. We now have the basics for our module. We have a module info, and we have a hello world command on the CLI, and our module is active, and we can now add more and more functionality. Thanks for joining us. Leave a like and let us know which topics you want to see in the future. Bye.